The land is in distress. It is witnessing widespread degradation, which ultimately could severely hit our food production capacity. One of the major factors contributing to it is unsustainable agricultural practices. We spoke about this in great detail in our previous videos. If you haven't watched them yet, please click the link above. In the last 5 decades, we lost 40% of the cultivable land. The human population isn't shrinking either. By 2050, it is projected to reach 9.8 billion. This means we'll need to produce 50 to 70% more food than today. So could we turn to the mighty oceans for food? No, I'm not talking about seafood. Instead, our focus is on seaweed, which forms the forests of the sea. Seaweed grows quickly. Unlike crops, it doesn't need fresh water or fertilizers to grow. These organisms are nutritious. However, seaweed is more than just food. And some experts believe these organisms could increase the ocean's potential of absorbing atmospheric carbon dioxide, mitigating the effects of climate change. Seaweeds are macroalgae. They, along with microalgae called phytoplankton, produce about 50 to 80% of the global oxygen. Like terrestrial plants, seaweeds consume carbon dioxide, water, and energy from the sun to produce food and oxygen. These organisms add colors to the sea, appearing in shades of green, brown, and red. Some measure a few millimeters or centimeters in size, while others grow to a height of 30 to 50 meters. Scientists have documented over 12,000 species of seaweeds. These marine algae are sought after by other industries. If you own a natural skincare lotion, chances are that it contains compounds derived from seaweed. It could be listed either as marine extract, extract of alga, or seaweed extract. These compounds are prized for their anti-aging, antioxidant, and moisturizing properties. For some, seaweed is a treat for the taste buds. If you've had sushi, you know what I'm talking about. The three main ingredients of the popular dish are raw fish, rice, and you guessed it, seaweed. So how is seaweed farmed? Seaweed farming is the practice of cultivating and harvesting seaweed. They're cultivated by attaching them to floating ropes in the waters. The harvested product is dried before selling it to the industry. The practice of cultivating seaweed began sometime in the late 1600s in Japan. They grew pyropia for food. About 10 seaweed species are cultivated widely. Among them, the brown algae Saccharina japonica, which is also called Japanese kelp, and the red algae Yushoma account for 66% of the global production. In 2016, seaweed production was estimated at 30.1 million wet tons globally. What about seaweed farming in India? India is blessed with a coastline of 8,100 km, and yet it has a lot of catching up to do. Gujarat and Tamil Nadu coasts are specially attractive for seaweed farming. The two states are home to 366 seaweed species, making up nearly half of India's total seaweed diversity. A red algae, Gracilaria edulis, is cultivated for agar, a gelatin-like product. It finds use as a thickener for soups, in food preserves, ice cream, and other desserts. Can seaweed farming ease climate change effects? It might. We'll tell you why some scientists think there is hope. First, we look at methane, a gas that has 28 times the heating potential of carbon dioxide. In our previous video, we showed you how livestock burps methane after digesting tough grasses. One cow can produce up to 200 kg of the gas a year. And there are 1.4 billion cattle in the world. A study suggested that feeding cattle seaweed might reduce methane emissions by as much as 82%. Land isn't the only entity in stress. The oceans are facing the brunt of human activities as well. Carbon dioxide dissolves in the ocean water. As the planet is getting warmer, the oceans are absorbing more carbon dioxide than usual. Between 1994 and 2007, oceans took in 34 gigatons of carbon dioxide. Oceans are typically alkaline. Before industrialization, the ocean pH was 8.2. But due to increasing carbon dioxide absorption, the number of hydrogen ions have increased, thereby making the waters slightly acidic. This has pushed the pH to about 8.1. Acidic waters could make life difficult for marine organisms. Scientists believe seaweed farming could remove enough carbon dioxide to reduce acidification. However, we need more research to confirm this. Seaweeds could find use even after death. Scientists think these organisms can carry carbon dioxide to the seabed and lock it up at the bottom for decades. A startup is developing a carbon removal technology using kelp, which is brown seaweed, to capture and store the greenhouse gas at the bottom. The Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change, IPCC, said there's not enough evidence to show how effective seaweeds are in locking up carbon, adding that it needs more research. While seaweed holds promise, we should ensure it doesn't become unsustainable. Widespread farming shouldn't disturb important habitats such as seagrass beds and coral reefs. That's a wrap on this edition of Explained. Don't forget to share your valuable feedback. Please subscribe to our channel for more such videos.